So very good morning students, welcome back to second year physics. So in the previous class actually we finished about a related to Einstein photoelectric equation and related graphs are over. Today now I want to say about a wave nature of a matter, that is de Broglie hypothesis. See, usually I want to say the universe is consist of with complete full of radiation. That means here complete full of light. Radiation in the sense is light. Actually radiation is nothing but electromagnetic wave. So that for that electromagnetic wave usually medium is not necessary. See, when this radiation or this light is, when it is enters into earth surface, into the earth atmosphere, so there will be a matter is there. So that the light is for itself, it's not required to propagate from one place to another place. Medium is not necessary. Light itself, it behave like a wave, of course. And we know the particles, coming to the particles, are nothing but like air particles or gas particles. Earth is trapped or the above the earth surface, atmosphere is located above 200 kilometers. So that this earth is completely with the particles, air particles. So that the particle is itself, it is behave like a particle nature. Light is itself, it behave like a particle nature. No, sorry, I'm sorry to say wave nature. Because the wave is nothing but a wave is nothing but a, we know in waves already it is a disturbance in the medium which propagated like this. The wave, the for wave, see, the wave is half the wavelength lambda, that will be there wavelength. So that the that we can call wave, and the particles are nothing but itself, it is a particle. And the light is when it is interacted with the particles or matter, with the matter. So suppose, so the light is propagating and the light is interacted with the particles. So when it is interacted, therefore this light is behave like a particle nature. It possesses the particle nature because which is interacted with the particles, no? So when it is interacted with the particles, therefore the wave behave like a particle nature. And as well as the particle also interacted with the wave, no, therefore the particle also behave like a wave. That's what we remember it is. So this is a very very important point. So that the light is interacted with the particles and the particle is interacted with the wave, therefore the both behave like a particle nature, like a wave nature. Itself it behave like a wave, and when it is interacted with the particles, therefore that behave like a particle nature. Now particle is behave like a particle itself. When particle is interacted with the wave, there it is to be what happens, it behave like a wave. So that it is about what it is related to the de Broglie hypothesis, according to the is assumption. That's what universe is completely consists of radiation and matter. Matter in the sense is the particles. Matter in the sense is we can call particles. So that it is completely with the mix of radiation and the matter. And according to the Einstein, you remember, in general nature is loves a symmetry. That means nature is loves a symmetry in the sense is what? Everywhere is to be same. The radiation and the matter should be same. That's what nature loves a symmetry. This is the first point. And here radiation has a dual nature, then matter also should have a dual nature, because it is completely mixed with one another, no? So that both behave like a duals. So according to the Einstein, you know, there is a particle energy. See, according to the Einstein, E is equal to mc square, right? This is we know. And also we know here is E is equal to mc is nothing but mc into c, we can. And here mc is nothing but a mass into velocity, we can say momentum it is. And energy E is nothing but we can say h nu it is. So that it is c by lambda we can, because lambda is nothing but a wavelength it is. So better this all information you substitute in the above equation. So hc by lambda is equal to p into c. So cc cancel, therefore p is equal to h by lambda. P is equal to h by lambda, that is we can say de Broglie wavelength is required, lambda is equal to h by p. So the p is nothing but we can call as the momentum. Momentum it is. H is nothing but we know Planck's constant. So this value of Planck's constant is, we know, 6.623 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. This is the one, right? And here P is, we know, and lambda is the wave length. See, wave length, what is this? Suppose waves, of course, for waves, wavelength is there. Suppose the particles, you take a particles. Suppose if a particles also, if there is a wavelength, then we can say the particle also behave like a waves. This is the de Broglie hypothesis. Our lambda is nothing but a de Broglie wavelength it is. Lambda is equal to h by p. Now I want to say another relation on this basis. We know there is a relation, kinetic energy is equal to p square by 2m. This is there in the first year. So p square is equal to, it is 2km. That is, k is nothing but a kinetic energy, m is nothing but a mass. So it is p is equal to 2km it is. Now let us, you write lambda is equal to h by root over 2km it is. This is the de Broglie wavelength, so which we can say in terms of kinetic energies. So suppose I want to say kinetic energy in terms of EV, or we can say QV, because V is nothing but a potential it is. It is related to potential, and Q is nothing but a charge. Charge of a given particles. You take a electron, of course we know charge of electron. Like proton, of course we know proton charge. Like you take a deuteron, we know deuteron charge. Alpha particle, neutron, and etc. So that the particles charge. So you write here lambda is equal to, from this lambda is equal to h by root over 2k. K is nothing but a q v m. This is the lambda of the particles. The particles, actually it possess the particle nature. When the light is interacted with the particles, therefore that behave like a wave. So if it is behaving like a wave, therefore the particle should obey the properties of lights, because light is interacting with the particles. No, light actually obeys the 7 to 8 properties. See, in this 7 to 8 properties, if the particles also behave like a wave, no, therefore the particle should obey the properties lights, property of lights, like diffraction, interference, like polarization, like you say reflection, refraction, rectilinear propagation. These properties should obey the particle, because the particle also now behave like a wave. No, wave is nothing but a, the particles are mixing with the light, with the radiation. Of course the light is obeys these all properties. Ultimately the particle also should obey the all properties. Then we can say yes, the particle also behave like a wave, and as well as the particle should have some wavelengths. If should have some wavelengths, then we can say the particle is behaving like a wave. Now I want to say some wavelengths related, right? By using this, let us, we'll discuss some wavelengths. Suppose here you take a electron. Electron is a particle. Now let us now we need to find a wavelength of an electron. Like I'll tell you all particles wavelengths, electron wavelength, so that lambda E is equal to, here you write h by root over 2 into q m v. V is the applied potential, q is the charge of electron, m is the mass of electron, h is the Planck's constant. Of course we know 6.623 into 10 power minus 34 it is, and charge of electron we know 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Mass of electron also we know, that is 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg it is. But we don't know this potential applied. We can call applied. How much is applied? This is we don't know. No, then you keep as applied only. Like you substitute these all values, and after substituting, get a simplification. We'll get the wavelength of a given a particle, right? Here, lambda electron is equal to h 6.023, I think 023 into 10 power minus 34 here. Right, by root 2 into charge 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, mass 9.1 into 10 power minus 31, and applied is we don't know. So if I take a simplification for this, so we'll get the wavelength of a electron will be like this. I'll show you the electron wavelength after simplification. It is approximately for electron is lambda electron is equal to, after this simplification, so it is becomes 12.27 by root V in angstroms, and lambda E, or else we can also write as 150 by V in angstroms. So now electron behave like a wave, because for electron wavelength is there, no? That's what it is. Let us go for the next particle. I'll give you next particle also. Let us, you write a for proton. You write as proton. So proton is P. Here the charge of proton is same. Mass of proton is, it is MP. Here this is will be changes. That is, you say 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg. Again, there you substitute these all values, just you change this one, because your only mass of the proton is different, 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg. Again, you take a simplification, there will get the answer is for a proton it is, right? Clear? For proton it is, what happens? It is approximately 0.86 by root V, right? Or else we can also say root over 0.082 by V in angstroms. So this is what it is related to, like a proton. So like you take other particles, let us, we have other particles like a neutron, you take a neutron and deuteron, alpha particles and etc. So that I'll write all wavelengths for a given particles. So that we'll get the idea. Suppose you go for the next particle. See, the next particle is for deuteron. So for deuteron particle, so we can write as lambda deuteron is equal to the value of this one, 0.202 by root E, it is in angstroms. And for next one, alpha particle, see, next one is alpha, that is, we can say is equal to 0.101 by root V angstroms. This is for alpha. And go for next particle, neutron. See, you say neutron it is, that is alpha, lambda neutron is equal to 0.86 by root E into angstroms. Like it is, we can say for the given different particles, these are the wavelengths range. So that now the particles like electron, proton, deuteron, alpha and etc., the particle itself would behave like a particles, and when it is mixed with the light, therefore there it is to be behave like a wave, because for them also some wavelengths are there, no? So that we can say the particle behave like a both light, or we can say wave and particle nature. This is an actually de Broglie's hypothesis. This is an de Broglie hypothesis. Clear? Now come to the point is, in this situation, again I want to say another expression also is there. From this is we can say kinetic theory of a gases. So in that kinetic theory of a gases, from first year KTG we can say, see, kinetic theory of a gases, there will be one formula is there, that is E is equal to 3/2 kT, right? E we can also say it is 1/2 mv². It is a kinetic energy, of course. So that here you write directly kinetic energy K, no? Here also we can take a K. So our lambda is equal to P by root over 2mkv, right? 2mkv. So better you substitute this value at K, then this is the K is nothing but a kinetic energy. This is you write as a KB. KB is nothing but a Boltzmann's constant. So it is, say it is H by root over 2mk is 3/2 kB T into, it is, we can say V. So 2 cancel. Then lambda is equal to H by root over, it is 3mkT into V. This is the related to in terms of Boltzmann's constant. So KB value how much? See, KB value is nothing but 1.38 into 10 power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. This is the Boltzmann's constant value. See, in terms of, in this also we can see, because the wavelengths again we need to find here, we need to write here. I'll tell you one or two particles wavelength. Suppose lambda for neutron. See, for neutron I am giving lambda for neutron is, that is lambda neutron is equal to approximately 30.8 root T into A. Sir, what is capital T? Capital T is nothing but we can say absolute temperature. Absolute scale of temperature, that is in Kelvins. Capital T represented as absolute scale of temperature. So this all represented as what? The wavelengths of a particles which are vibrated or which are mixed with the light, therefore that possess a, what it is, we can say both wave nature as well as we can say particle nature. Clear? And here about this related to de Broglie wavelengths and de Broglie hypothesis. And one more point I want to tell you, on the basis of this, in NEET examination or in the other objective examination like JEE mains, MCET, usually they are asking two questions on the basis of this concept. Better you remember this concept is very, very important, right? And here there is another one is there. Suppose see, there is a like a de Broglie, like you know, angular momentum of electrons. It is in case of a Bohr atom model, you know, Bohr angular momentum, L is equal to, you know, it is nh by, angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. This is an actually what we can say related to the angular momentum of Bohr atomic model, angular momentum we can say like, so that here we know L is equal to, we can also write as mvr. So mvr is equal to nh by, we can say 2 pi. Here mv is nothing but a momentum, no? So we know lambda is equal to, it is h by mv because it is momentum. So from here mv is equal to h by lambda. Better you write here. Then what happens, we'll see. See, it is h lambda r, I'm sorry, hr by lambda is equal to nh by 2 pi. This h is cancelled. So r is equal to n lambda by 2 pi. This r is nothing but a radius, right? It is the radius of the given orbit. Clear? It is the radius of the given orbit. So that here it is n lambda is equal to 2 pi into r. It's nothing but a rn. R is, rn is nothing but a, see, radius of the nth orbit. Radius of the nth orbit. We can say like this. Radius of the nth orbit, nr. So because in case of a Bohr atom model, we know this is about a, what it is, we can say lambda is equal to, from here we can write as 2 pi rn by n. So this is the lambda wavelength of a given a particles. So we know radius also, we know according to the Bohr orbit, first orbit in hydrogen atom, it is equal to what happens, 0.53 into n square angstroms it is. So better here you write lambda is equal to, it is 2 pi by n into, we can say 0.53 into n square in angstrom. So one n is cancelled, lambda is equal to 2 pi into 0.53 n lambda angstroms it is. So that here the particles are mixing with, suppose I'll show you the wave nature. So the, you know, in waves, the wave is us and it is incident like this, and which is to be reflected back like this, right? Like particle also same, when particle is moving from one place to another place, and when it is incident at a one end and it is reflected back as like a wave. So that I will show you in the nth orbit. Suppose you take a, according to the Bohr radius, so there will be, this is the radius of the Bohr orbit. So that the particles which are, so it is to be propagating like this, you take the wave will be like this. This is related to what? It is like a wave nature. So that here the wave, it is, the light is propagating like this. So in a similar way, there will be particles. The particles also, it is possess the wave, no? So you take a particles
like this. The particle is moving and it is to be like this. Like this.
So this radius of this given orbit is, you say, r. So lambda of this particle 2 pi into, we can say, 0.53 n into angstroms, or else you want to write directly lambda is equal to this expression. It is 2 pi r n by n. R n is nothing but a nth orbit radius. You say nth orbit radius, that's what it is. We can say related to Bohr orbits. Bohr orbits, according to the angular momentum, this is given by the Bohr explanation related to the de Broglie wavelengths. Clear? So that you go through this, because it is also is there in our syllabus. So better you refer this, and it is about what it is related to de Broglie's concept. Right? So this is about it today's class, and we'll see in the next class. Thank you very much. Thank you.